Hey everybody, this is Michael once again. A little bit under the weather, but feeling better. Yesterday I saw a film that's called The Hunger Games, and I've actually been wanting to see this film for quite some time, so we finally decided to check it out. That's my girlfriend and I. And I thought I'd give you my thoughts on the movie. Now this movie, wow, has been just a box office juggernaut. It's made domestically $300 million, and I believe it's made about $200 million overseas. So the movie's doing great. Now I do know that this film is based upon a series of books, and I've never read any of the books, never even heard of the books until this film came out, so I'm not at all familiar with the books or the universe within those books, so I'm not quite sure how faithfully the film has been translated from the book. But anyway, The Hunger Games, basically, to go over the story just a little bit, guys, it's about a post-apocalyptic world somewhere in the United States called Paynum. Now, I'm assuming that Paynum, if I'm pronouncing that correctly, is made up of remaining states in the U.S. And also in North America now, the lands are divided into 12 districts. Now, apparently at one time, there was an uprising between all these districts where they tried to take over the capital. And as punishment, they have been having these yearly events called the Hunger Games. That's where they pick one girl and one boy from each district, and basically they battle to the death. And in the film, we have a young girl and a young boy from District 12. And what's the girl's name? Jennifer Lawrence plays the young woman from District 12. And I'm trying to think of her name in the film. Her name is Katniss. Jennifer Lawrence plays a character named Katniss. And the guy's name in the film, the character name, is PETA. Not the animal PETA. But sounds just like it. But anyway, they are the chosen ones from District 12. Turn my lights off. And in the film, the film pretty much shows the angle of the games from their point of view. So you're kind of getting the insight on how they feel about the games, their experience through the games. And all the other districts, they're there, but you don't really see, learn anything as much as characters go about the other districts. They're kind of, the characters from the district are never, the other districts are never really touched on very much. The focus is on Jennifer Lawrence and Josh Hutcherson's character, PETA. And right off the bat, guys, I got to tell you that if you've seen the film, the Asian film, the Japanese film, Battle Royal, or Battle Royale, this film is definitely a takeoff on that film. Although I got to tell you that I'm probably a bigger fan of Battle Royal, simply for the fact that it's a better paced film. And to me, Battle Royale is just more satirical in the way it's presented on film, because it's just so over the top, just so wildly entertaining that it's just satirical. It's just it presents the violence and this and that at a point where it's so extreme that it's unbelievable, and at the same time it's making fun of just how extreme violence is. But anyway, Jennifer Lawrence plays Katniss, and then we have a few other stars that I definitely recognize. We have Lenny Kravitz, who kind of plays her publicist, or their publicist. And then we have Woody Harrelson, who, you know, I'm a big fan of Woody Harrelson. Just whatever he's in is just usually really, really good. He's just good in everything he's in. He's really good in this film. I liked him. Provided probably a lot of character in this film. I mean, you know, of course we have a lot of development with Jennifer Lawrence's character and PETA, But Woody Harrelson's character is so well put together that when you see him, he's just pretty much developed just from a few sentences that he says. So this film, also I would compare it to The Running Man. So, you know, now you know the basic setup of the story. You know, you live, you fight, and you die. I mean, in the film, you know, there's only going to be one survivor. So even though you may have two people from your district, only one of you are going to survive as far as the rules go in the game. And like I said, pretty much without even going too much further into the story, there you have it. You know, it's a fight for survival in this film with Jennifer Lawrence's character being the focus. You see the games through her eyes. You see the world through her eyes. And that's what you see. So, guys, we have a story that has some, for the most part, some really developed characters. I mean, you know, you have Katniss, whose development is probably more focused on than any other characters. And like I said, Woody Harrelson, just great in the film. I really liked his character. Then we have PETA, who's developed in the film. Donald Sutherland plays the president of the... Okay, car, it ain't like they were going to turn way out in your lane. Donald Sutherland plays the president of the capital city. He's actually over all the districts. And the way the games are set up, they're kind of like current-day sporting events. You have certain sponsors for each district. You have the characters trying to build up sponsorship. So it's really kind of a sporting event. It's really commercialized in this. You know, each team is given a person to educate them on the games, and then they're given someone to build up their charisma so that they'll be sponsored, so that they'll be popular. So it's really commercialized, and you know, with little emphasis actually given to the actual deaths in the film. So you don't have a whole lot of time spent on the gruesomeness of the deaths. And, you know, as far as the film goes itself on an entertainment level, having not read any of the books, so if you are fans of the books and I say something that is wrong, please forgive me. But as far as the film's concerned, I think it runs for about 2 hours and 25 minutes. And I got to tell you guys, you know, that time, I believe, was spent well. I mean, we did get that much-needed character development that, you know, a lot of films don't throw in today. But at the same time, you know, I got to tell you that I've seen many films with a lot shorter running time with characters that are equally developed. So, in my opinion, the running time on the film is way too long. And I would even say that it should have been cut by about 30 minutes. Because, you know, starting out, it does take a long time for the action to get on screen. And the film does come across as... really, really slow. And of course I saw this with my girlfriend and the kids, and as a matter of fact, a couple of my kids fell asleep. So it is a slow film. I will give it that. It is slow. I think a lot of the material in the film could have been cut. I think it should have been, the movie should have gone through a second edit to speed up things. Now, being a fan of Battle Royal and a fan of The Running Man, these types of films, I think are interesting, because first and foremost, I think they touch on a part of us, perhaps even a savage part of us, where we want to be kind of a voyager in this and see, you know, people just cutting down other people, you know, being put in that situation where you've got to fight for your life. And you always, when you see these kind of movies, I always wonder if me and my best friend were thrown into a situation like this, would you really kill your best friend? So it's interesting stuff, you know. And I think that not focusing on the gruesomeness of the deaths in the film, that I think it actually was kind of a detriment to the movie. I mean, I thought it was a well-made film with a good score and everything, but overall, I liked it, but I didn't like it a whole lot. And it's just because I've seen better, guys. I've seen better movies in this style. I know this film has been a huge hit. A lot of people have really, really loved this film. And if you're one of those, more power to you. The movie just didn't do a lot for me. While I appreciated the character development, what the film was trying to say about, you know, real-world government, the plight of the poor, the savageness of violence and all this, I also got to say that I just really, really was turned off by the slow pacing of the film. And also, guys, let me say that another actress in the film, Amanda Stenberg. Now, a lot of you won't know who she is, but she hadn't been in a whole lot. She was in that farce of the movie Columbiana. She played the little girl. She also plays a character in this movie called Rue. And I was really impressed by her performance. She did an excellent job in the film. Participated in the most emotionally charged scene in the film. And I also got to say, guys, that, you know, on an emotional level, the plight that these people were in, being forced to battle to the death, just for me, guys, it just wasn't really much of an emotional draw for me. And I know you guys are thinking, oh, Mike, you're down on all these films. I'm not really down on the movie. I just have seen better, guys. And, you know, that's all there is to it. I've seen better. Like I said, I liked it, but I didn't like it a whole lot. And I think that there's a lot of people that probably won't like the film, despite the fact that the movie has made quite a bit of money. But I think it's an okay movie. I really can't recommend it. I think I would have to see it again and maybe get a different perspective on it, because there's lots of times when I see a movie for the first time, it just seems like it moves so slowly. And this is one that I need to see again to get a different perspective on. But as it stands now, guys, it's just not my cup of tea. It's an okay film, a well-made film, but just nothing that I want to rush out and see again. So with that said, guys, while I rooted for Katniss at times during the film, I just was really turned off by the long running time. I think they could have achieved their goal in a less running time than what they put on screen here. But anyway, guys, thanks for watching, everybody. Take care, and I'll see you at the next movie review.